Hello and welcome to another edition of Mailbag. What is Mailbag? Well, Mailbag is a feature of the channel where you guys leave lots of comments on the channel and I attempt to answer those comments, or if I can't answer those comments, I throw it out to you guys who have more knowledge on some of this stuff than I do. So, let's get into the first mailbag of this session. Remember, like, comment, subscribe to the channel. Go over to Instagram and follow me there. Go over to Facebook, follow me there. That's where the normal notices are. And consider becoming a Patreon. Next comment or question comes from Rob Smith at 5231. And he writes, in response to the Roland A-80, Roland D-05 and Domira, a SMR idea way back in September 2017. Hey John, great to find your vid. Just inherited an A-80 and desperately looking for any Roland A-80 for Dummies kind of thing. The manual is much beyond my reach. Any suggestions would be much appreciated. I've got to be honest and say most of the Roland manuals from the 80s and 90s were unintelligible unless you spoke Roland geek. You could work it out. Don't get me wrong. You can work it out. You can work out how to do things, but it wasn't the easiest thing in the world to follow. And to be honest, some manuals haven't really learned their lesson from that perspective. YouTube is a wonderful resource. And I do intend to do more videos on the Roland A80, which, as with the A50, were very, very functional MIDI controllers. They also weigh half a ton each, and you need three roadies to move them around. But they were very, very functional and built to last. These things were built for the road. You know, don't get me wrong, they really were built for the road. They're built like tanks. And, you know, while the MIDI controller and the Roland A80 and other, you know, the Yamaha KX88, etc., etc., weren't exactly what you would call sexy in the modern computer-driven environment we work in nowadays, they work fantastically in a non-DAW environment. And there is quite a lot to be said for a non-DAW environment. Next one, or next comment or question, comes from CRLFNKL. I don't know what that spells. And this was in response to the Korg T1, the basics video I did in March 2023. And CRL writes, your videos have been instrumental in getting my T1 to work. Thank you, however, I'm wondering if I can ask a question. Well, this is what this section of the channel is all about. Asking questions and getting answers with a bit of luck. It seems to be crashing my computer when I'm using a DAW. And the T1 as the main MIDI controller. I'm wondering if it can be due to a clock source being set to internal. The problem is I cannot set it to external. I set it to external in the global manual, but then restarting it resets the internal after it starts up. All of the other settings, such as MIDI channel, however, are saved. I have not found any info when setting this clock when searching the interwebs. Hoping somebody has some input. All the best. Well, always thank you for the feedback. And now, I'm struggling a bit to understand why the Korg T1 would crash your DAW. In actual fact, MIDI is actually a very, very basic protocol. And the MIDI that the Korg T1 pushes out is actually pretty simple. And I suspect the issue is probably related to your MIDI to USB interface not handling the signal conversion correctly. That's where I think the problem would be. So I'd probably try it with another interface. So if you can borrow an interface, beg, steal, or borrow an interface from somebody and try it. Now, I always use a very simple interface. I use for trying this stuff where I think I've got MIDI problems. So I use just a MIDI Sport 2 in, 2 out. And the amount of times I can debug things really, really quickly with a MIDI Sport 2 in, 2 out, it was worth the money it cost me to buy that to replace the previous MIDI support that went out of the drivers went out of support. So that's kind of where I'd be looking. And to be honest, unless you're running a sequencer from the Korg, the clock being external or internal really should be quite irrelevant. If the DAW is set to internal, then it will be using the computer's clock irrespective of what receives a time code from the MIDI instrument. So basically, the protocol should ignore any clock timing signals coming from any other sources because it's set to internal. So it will use the internal clock to trigger any MIDI that it needs to send out and any timing signatures it needs to send out. That will all be generated from the internal clock. So I can't see why the Korg T1 clock would potentially be crashing your DAW. That I don't see. I don't understand that. You do have to be careful when operating mergers that you don't have two clock signals competing with each other. So, you know, if you are merging MIDI signals at some point in your MIDI chain, you can't just bosh the cables together. You do actually need a logic converter that will actually put the signals together. And the other thing you need to do is make sure that all the MIDI instruments that you're using are using the same clock source if you're doing something like that. So that's another kind of tip. Now, in terms of MIDI on the Korg T1, while there is a global receive channel, you actually set the MIDI, you set the receive channels on the programmed and combis that are being selected. Okay, so I hope that clears things up. And to send MIDI data, as you correctly surmise, you go into the global settings and it will be set by default to channel 1. So if you want to change it to a different channel, that's where you do it. Now, I'm not in front of my T1 when I wrote this response. So this next bit is coming, might not be correct. But if you set up a split in a combi, you should always be able to send the MIDI info from the split points on different channels. But that is a long time since I had to set my T1 up in that sort of mode. So I'm still saying this from memory. And I tend to play into the DAW or the sequencer and let the target device manage the separation rather than the T1 actually separating the splits. Hopefully that makes an awful lot of sense. But if it doesn't, drop me a line.